What's up, MMO Attack fans? This is Super Zero here, bringing you a first impressions video for the Lord of the Rings Online, a free-to-play MMORPG published by Turbine Interactive. Okay, here's the character selection screen. We don't have a character currently created, so we're going to go ahead and create a new character. So, of course, you just click the new character button, and here's your character creation options. As you can see, you can choose from between about four races and several different classes, and there is a male and female version of each race, which is always nice. And you can pick the humans, the dwarves, the hobbits, and the elves. And of course you can see the background changes depending on which race you pick, which is always kind of cool. I think we'll go with the humans. And there's a number of classes you can pick from. Now keep in mind that all races can't be every class. For example, the human cannot be the runekeeper. You can tell because the class option is grayed out and you can click it all you want to, but you can never ever select it. So we'll go with the guardian. Make him the guardian is like the warrior or tank class in Lord of the Rings Online. So we'll click continue. And here's some character customization. It's fairly standard, very similar to a lot of other MMORPGs on the market today. However, there is one unique feature here. You can select your origin, and I'm not sure what exactly this feature does for the game, but it does sort of alter your character's appearance ever so slightly. You can tell when you select your origin is in Brelands, you sort of have a much lighter skin tone than, for example, if you selected Gondor, and I'm not sure what that is or what all that affects once you get into the game itself. However, if I'm not mistaken, you do get a special title depending on where you select your origin. So we'll go ahead and say we're from Rohan, and then you have a wide variety of different facial types and hairstyles. Things are very, very you do have a wide variety of different hairstyles and things, but you don't have total control over your character customization. You can only select from one of several different pre-made options. So we'll go with those eyebrows. And as far as your mouth customization here, this is basically just like your lip color. So do you want really red lips, or do you want pale lips, or somewhere kind of in between? I think we'll go with in between. And then details. So for the humans, I think it means different things depending on which race you are. But for the humans, you can actually have a scar. So I kind of like that scar across his eye. We'll leave that. Body type. Of course, you can be super skinny or kind of bulky. We'll go somewhere in the middle. We'll try to get it back to default. We're going to go ahead and randomize a name. What I like about this random name feature in Lord of the Rings Online is a lot of random name features. Well, a lot of MMORPGs have random name features when you create your character, but they give you such stupid names. It just seemed like a bunch of random characters strung together. But in Lord of the Rings Online, the random names they give you actually seem like they would fit in the Lord of the Rings setting, so that's always kind of cool. So we'll go ahead and click Create, and it's going to take us to a new user tutorial, which shouldn't take us that long to finish. Oh, that name is taken. Well, that was a completely random name. Okay, let's try it again. All right, here we go. And we're going to, or now that we've got our character created, we're going to go ahead and click Enter Middle Earth. Okay, we're in game now. And as you can see, everything's very standard. The user interface is very much standard fare for this sort of game. And we have a little tutorial window. We're going to go ahead and close out of that and click Do Not Show Hints in the Future, because we know how to play this game. Doesn't really deviate from the norm. As you can see, the user interface is very, very similar to World of Warcraft. And this game was released in 2007 and is really what I consider one of the first games to really be a sort of WoW clone, if you will. This game was really one of the first games to take the WoW model of gameplay and really copy it or attempt to emulate its success. And it has done relatively well for itself in terms of there's been a lot of other free-to-play MMORPGs, or not free-to-play, but there have just been a lot of other MMORPGs in general that have tried to do the same thing and have had much less success. And I don't know why it's giving me another tutorial window, because I already checked the Do Not Show This Hint in the Future box. Oh, Do Not Show This Hint in the Future. So apparently, if I want to get rid of all tutorials, I'm going to have to do something else, but I don't necessarily know what to do. So we'll just have to deal with the tutorial. So we'll click the satchel here and open the satchel. And I'm going to get a hatchet and a wood kite shield. So, of course, you can open up your bags. You can press the B key, which opens up all your bags. Or, yeah, no, I'm sorry. You can press the I key to open up all your bags. And as you can see, it's very similar to World of Warcraft, again, with the bag-based inventory system. You have multiple inventory windows which open up. And I've never really been a fan of that. I'm glad that a lot of MMOs are getting away from that. I think maybe they had that in for immersion. For example, if you had 5 bags of inventory, well, you have 5 inventory windows because you're getting certain items out of certain bags. But it made inventory management an absolute nightmare. And in World of Warcraft, you can sort of circumvent that by downloading add-ons. But to my knowledge, Lord of the Rings Online has no add-ons, so you're kind of stuck with it if that's what you want to do. So, let's see. Well, it looks like my character automatically equipped those items, so we don't even need to equip them. So we'll go ahead and close out all this inventory stuff here and close this. Let's talk to Strider, see what he has to say. You should practice combat. Yeah. Okay, again, combat is very, very simple, so we're just going to, well, we're going to wait till this guy becomes targetable. It says get set, so anytime now. Fight. Okay. You see that little sword icon down in the bottom middle next to your skills, to the left of your skills? You just click that and or you double-click the enemy and you'll start automatically attacking. There are 3 abilities we have right now. Guardian's Ward, Shield Blow, and Sting. Guardian's Ward is a melee skill that enables me to strengthen my defenses for a short amount of time. Shield Blow strikes the opponent with your shield, just generates additional threat. And Sting is a quick attack that will lightly wound your opponent. And interestingly enough, this game, again, is very much a hotkey MMORPG, very standard combat, but it does allow skill queuing, which is pretty much if you press a lot of buttons or you click a lot of the buttons in rapid succession, it queues the abilities up. So you can press, say, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in rapid order, and then you can watch your character go through the list of skills 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in that order. So you don't exactly have to press the buttons in real time because the skills will queue up for you, which is kind of unique. I don't know a lot of MMOs that actually do that. So now we have to follow Strider outside. Let's see where he's going to go. And as you can see by the art style of this game, in no means does it follow the Peter Jackson Lord of the Rings universe. It's not really the Peter Jackson Middle Earth. It's more based off of the books. And it's sort of in between realistic and cartoony. It's not incredibly realistic. It's very much stylized, but it's not cartoony. It's not like a Disney cartoon. World of Warcraft is very, very much like a Disney cartoon, I think. Okay, so we got that quest, and we have to kill 4 captors. It looks like they're just going to bum rush us here, so we'll go ahead and see what we can do. So let's go ahead and target this guy, and we'll go ahead and use our shield blow. And as you can see, watch what happens right there. Takes care of him real quick. And we just leveled up. We didn't level up. I was reading the hint there. It was telling me something about experience, but I don't need to know anything about that. This game plays very much like all the other MMORPGs out there. There's not a lot that, and that's the thing about games like Lord of the Rings. There's not much of a learning curve. Pretty much, if you've played World of Warcraft or any similar game, Rift, or if you've played EverQuest 2, or I'm trying to think of a Warhammer Online, you've played this game. So there's not much of there's more of a, I would say, a learning curve towards the end game. But if you just want to jump in and start playing, it's not very difficult at all. Again, you've been up and down this road before. What's this say? Drama. Many stories in Middle-earth will unfold before your eyes. Be sure to pay attention to these events, blah, blah, blah. Basically, that's just telling me that every now and then my gameplay is going to be interrupted by some story-based cutscenes. This game is one of the very first MMORPGs, if not the very first MMORPG, to incorporate a storyline that you yourself are actually a part of. You know, a lot of MMORPGs have storylines, if not all of them. But your character's always kind of on the sidelines, meaning that you sort of watch as things happen and you read about it, you hear about it from other sources, but you don't actually take part in that. Well, in Lord of the Rings Online, of course, yes, you don't play as Frodo or Aragorn or Legolas or Gimli. You're not actually going to Mount Doom to throw away the One Ring, but there is a storyline that directly involves you. You actually get involved in the process, or you actually get involved in helping Aragorn and helping Frodo and helping the rest of the Fellowship of the Ring complete their mission. So now that I've killed all those guys, I have to talk to this little halfling here. Defeat Mundo's captor. Let's see. Is he going to come out here? Or what do I have to do here? I'm just going to follow her right now. What's she doing? She's setting fire to... Like she's setting fire to that house. So I imagine he's going to come out here any second. Now, okay, she wants me to follow her, so I'm going to do that. I'm going to follow her, see where she's going to take me. And I'm going to go in here. There's the guy I have to kill. So, again, we're going to use Shield Bash, and then we're going to use our melee skill and Sting. I think that... let's see. Between that and my first ability, those are my two main DPS abilities. So let's see. Let's talk to this guy here. Find Strider and Amdir. Gotcha. So they're going to unlock this gate for me, and I'm going to go in this way. And here's one of the story-based cutscenes that I was talking about. So it's really not a cutscene. I don't mean to say cutscene, but sort of. It's a story sequence that's happening in the game. There's not a lot you can do to alter the story sequence, but you can move around your character freely and interact with the game world while it's going on, which to me is always... It's a little bit more immersive than watching a cutscene. As much as I like the storyline in Star Wars The Old Republic, I prefer this kind of storytelling above the storytelling in The Old Republic, in that I feel like I never do lose control of my character. I'm always in control of my character. And of course, right now, I'm unable to move, but that's because that NPC placed a debuff on me. I could still pan my character around, and it was still in-game, actually. In the game, it wasn't a cutscene, but of course, I just couldn't move and consequently alter the course of events. And talk to that guy, and something special happens to Amdir. I won't ruin it for you, but something happens to him in the near future. It's kind of cool. Not so much cool for Amdir, but just cool for the story in general. Okay, after we completed that, we're now actually out of the newbie tutorial. This, while we're still in a bit of a newbie zone that I don't think we can get out of until we complete a certain number of quests, we are actually in the greater game world. We're no longer in an instance in all sorts of other newbies. You can see player characters running around. These are all actual people. We're now actually in the game. So we're going to talk to this chick right here who has a quest for us. You can see quest NPCs are a little bit different in this game. Instead of there being an exclamation point over their head and a question mark, there's a little ring over their heads. And if you want to get a quest, they have the ring here. It's in yellow. And then when you're ready to turn in a quest, the ring will be burning. So we have to go talk to Amdir, and after we talk to Amdir, of course, we're going to get a quest reward. We're going to get a new chest piece. So let's talk to Amdir, continue the quest, and I guess we have to talk to Strider. And yeah, here we go. We can choose from cloth or leather. Well, we're a taint class, so we're going to use leather. Eventually, you'll be able to use chain and plate mail as you level up, so we'll go ahead and equip that. And, okay... I guess now is just as good a time as any. Look at this. Look at this chess piece. I don't know. It's between Lord of the Rings Online and Star Wars The Old Republic. Those two games have the worst armor design of any MMORPG I've ever played. Now, to be fair, the armor design for Lord of the Rings is really, really bad at the low and mid levels, but it's actually pretty good as you get to higher levels. And you can go to the Lotro store here, just press the little turbine, the turbine store icon, which is to the very far right on your middle, on your hotbar there at the bottom middle. You just click that. And you can get some points, of course, and then you can get all sorts of cosmetic gear, which is basically appearance armor. And let me show you some of the stuff. We can go over here where it says clothing, and let's see. Headwear, where is it at? Well, I just saw it the other day, but I can't find it right now, and I don't want to waste time on that. But you can buy some appearance armor, which looks a lot like high-level armor to circumvent the fact that most of the low-level armor looks like crap. And that's what I did when, last time I played. I subscribe to this game every time I want to play it. I rarely ever go back and play it as a free player. Whenever I play Lord of the Rings, I actually do subscribe. And when you do subscribe, you get a monthly stipend of turbine points, which you can then put forth towards appearance armor. you expansions, mounts, whatever you want. So we're going to go ahead and talk to Captain Brackenbrook here, see what he has to say. Looks like he's going to send me around to talk to a bunch of people. And let me see if I can remember. Oh, yeah. Let's see. Not the T key. Which button is it? Oh, yeah. If you press the J key, it brings up the traits window. And you have virtues and all these different traits. And I don't know enough about the variations of all the different traits in this game and what they do and what I need and what I don't need. But I will say that this game has a deeds system. And what I mean by a deeds system is this game, Lord of the Rings, predates the whole achievements craze in MMORPGs. When World of Warcraft added achievements to their game, and Rift has achievements to their game. They don't really have achievements in this game. Actually, it does something a little... It has something very, very similar. It has deeds, which is basically, okay, kill 100 orcs, and you kill 100 orcs, and you're rewarded with some kind of a stat bonus, like plus 3 strength, or plus 10 agility, and things like that. And it seems like... And I can almost see the developers at Turbine thinking to themselves, well, this is just a little bonus that people can do when they're playing the game. We don't actually intend for you to go out and kill 100 orcs and then kill 100 goblins and then kill 100 wolves or wargs. We don't actually intend for you to do that, to grind that out like that. But in practice, what happens is when you get to in-game, you're going to be expected to have certain traits. Now, you're going to research that yourself and figure out which traits you're going to have, but you're going to have certain traits. So that is going to mean that you are going to have to grind out those traits. And if you're like me, you absolutely hate that. And I got to be honest with you when I say that that's really one of the reasons why I don't even play Lord of the Rings Online. I think that that feature pretty much sabotages the game in general. Fellowship invitation. Well, I really don't have time for the fellowship invitation right now. I'm sorry. I'll have to maybe explain to her later why I don't. But anyway, it just kind of sabotages the entire game because it's such a grind and it's just not fun. I don't know anybody that actually thinks of it as being fun. Now, you take a game like... I don't want to spar with you. Now, you take a game like World of Warcraft, which has similar stat buffs, but they're in skill trees. So every time you level up, you just press a button and put points in a skill tree. And in Turbine's previous MMORPG, Asheron's Call 2, a game that in many ways is a precursor to Lord of the Rings Online, both in terms of the game engine and general mechanics, it's the same way. It's a skill tree. So why doesn't Lord of the Rings have a skill tree? Why do they make you grind out monsters to get the same benefits that you would get from a skill tree, which in so many other MMORPGs just requires you to level up? I suppose if you played this game casually and you didn't care about raiding at the end game or any of that stuff, then you actually could play through the entire game and not grind through any traits or not grind the deeds that you have to do. But I'm going to tell you this right now. If you want to raid, you're probably going to have to do that. And games of this nature, unless you really like re-rolling other characters, if you don't raid, then well, you might as well quit and play something else whenever you hit the level cap. So we have to to finish up this quest, we have to talk to one more guy here. You know, I hate how a lot of these newbie games, you know, or a lot of these newbie areas in these MMORPGs, you just basically go around talking to NPC after NPC. I want to go ahead and start killing something. So now we're going to visit the... He just gave us a quest to visit the Guardian Trainer. And, yeah, I should mention this too. This game, again, let me emphasize this point. You get all your skills from trainers. It's very, 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 very similar to other MMOs. And, well, she's going to give me a quest, but this is also telling me that I can train... strike the training dummy with a shield swipe, and I can get some of this stuff here. Where's the training dummy? So we'll do that real quick. Let's see. Shield swipe or shield... Oh, okay. Maybe that means I have to get the skill. I didn't have it before. Train guardian skills. Yeah, shield swipe. Level 2, I'm going to train. And the ability, of course, automatically goes on my hotbar. Shield swipe. After successfully blocking an enemy blow, you may attack with both your weapon and shield. This skill draws the enemy's attention to yourself. So it's just another taunt ability that your character has. And so we did that. Now we're going to talk to the trainer again. And intro. And we get one shield automatically, but we can choose between a blade, an axe, and a mace. And I think I'm going to pick the blade, so I'm going to click finish now. I'm going to click that and equip my brand new newbie armor, and then I'm going to go talk to Strider. And this is probably not a spoiler, but of course Strider being Aragorn, who we'll find out later. Talk to him and finish the quest now. The Lotro store, we know all about the Lotro store. Blah blah blah. Ask Captain Brackenbrook. You can pull up the map by pressing the M key. Again, it looks very, very similar to World of Warcraft. It's sort of that old scroll look to it, and it takes up the entire screen, which actually World of Warcraft got away from that. The map, you can enlarge the map to be the entire screen in WoW, but I believe by default it is smaller now. But this game does appear to be a bit behind the curve. Let's see, we have to get some King's Foil over in this direction. Of course, you can press the M key again, and you see that area that's highlighted in red there? That's where we have to go. In this game, this is one of the first MMOs that I can remember to have a built-in quest helper. Quest helper being, of course, it tells you where to go to complete your quest. And I remember, in World of Warcraft, you didn't have a quest helper. You had a built-in quest helper for several years. You had add-ons, though, that would basically do that for you. And this game comes built-in with a quest helper, which I think is really cool. And actually, I would say World of Warcraft, that's one thing World of Warcraft stole from this game, was the inclusion of a quest helper. Because quest helpers, as a default feature in MMORPGs, that wasn't really as prevalent until this game came out. So a lot of people blame World of Warcraft for a lot of, you know, people that don't like quest helpers, people that say that quest helpers really dumb down the game. A lot of people blame World of Warcraft for that, but World of Warcraft or Blizzard never actually implemented that feature until it was already a staple in several other MMORPGs. You know, Lord of the Rings being the first that I can think of. So really, if you want to blame somebody, blame Turbine for that. We have to kill one more of these wolves, and you can pretty much two-shot these guys. Very, very easy. Yeah, I got him. Looks like where we're going now is pretty much the same place. I have to kill, probably going to be some kind of a named wolf at the top of those ruins there, and I have to get some plants at the top of those ruins. So I killed that wolf. I didn't have to kill him, but he was in my way, and I'm not sure if he would have aggroed me. I don't think so. I think their names have to be in red for them to aggro you, but I don't quote me on that. I'm not sure. I haven't actually. You know, this low-level stuff you don't have to worry about, but I haven't actually played my level 40 in any kind of a serious fashion. I haven't played him in quite a while, so I don't remember. And we have three King's Foil plants, and I'm going to get one more, but we're going to attack this guy. Is this the guy I have to kill? I don't know. I don't think so. Yeah, that's just another random mob. So we got the King's Foil plants. Now let's go. Let's go up here. Let's see. Where is he? Maybe he's up here. I don't know. Search atop. Yeah. Use the Black Walled Banner to summon the offender. So we'll do that. We have to click on this flag. The Wolf Master approaches. You must defeat him. The Wolf Master. One thing about this game is it reuses a lot of the same art assets. Mr. Wolfmaster here looks pretty much like every other bandit in the entire game. And these ruins here, I'm not sure what ruins they are, but you better get used to seeing them, because if there's a ruin in Lord of the Rings Online, it looks almost, it uses the exact same textures. It looks almost like the exact same thing. Now that we've completed those quests, I think that shows you guys enough about the game. So that's it for this first impressions video of Lord of the Rings Online. If you like the video, feel free to rate, comment, and subscribe. For more content, visit MMOattack.com for MMO gaming news, reviews, opinions, giveaways, and other general awesomeness.